Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Motoroids. Today we'll be talking about the new Mahindra XUV 300, which joins the Mahindra XUV range as a younger brother to the Mahindra XUV 500. In terms of design, it is inspired by the Mahindra XUV 500's cheetah-inspired design, and that is very apparent when you take a look at the front. For instance, those headlights. It gets these DRLs, which are placed at the top, and they also drop down vertically towards the fog lamps. The headlamps, by the way, have been embedded with LEDs, which we believe is reserved for the top spec variant. Also, if you take a look at the grille, it takes a lot of inspiration from the XUV 500's front grille. At the bottom, if you look at the air dam, there are horizontal running chrome strips which enhance the width of the car, and overall the face is quite in sync with Mahindra's design language. Apart from that, you also get these aggressive looking creases on the bonnet which accentuate a few sharp lines in the design of the vehicle. Moving over to the sides, you do have these blacked out pillars A, B and C, all of them, where the C pillar in particular translates into a floating effect for the roof, which by the way also has these aluminium finished roof rails, a normal antenna, no shark fin stuff here, and the sunroof too, which is quite a nice addition. If you look at the bottom though, wheel arches at the front and back do mimic the design on the XUV 500, and beneath that you get these diamond cut alloy wheels, which are quite the rage these days. Apart from that, there's also black cladding which surrounds the car all over, and overall, although the car looks boxy, it has these lines and curves which are sharp, which make it look a little aggressive. Moving at the back, you do get this spoiler which gets an integrated stop lamp, a windscreen which is sort of tiny in size by the looks of it in these pictures, and beneath that you get these tail lights which do look quite a lot like the units on the Altura's G4, and these come with LEDs embedded inside too. The bumper is quite large, as a result of which the tailgate should open and shut at quite a height, and apart from that, the bumper also gets housings for a reflector and a fog lamp. You also get a silver finish for skid plate at the rear, and that sums up the overall picture for the Mahindra XUV 300. On the inside, you get upholstery which is finished in a shade of black and white, white being the prominent shade which should enhance the roominess and space factor on the inside. Apart from that, you get the steering wheel which has silver finished inserts, buttons, and there are buttons to control the infotainment system as well as cruise control and the multi-information display in the instrument console. You also get red finished dials, red needles, an information display in the center which, although is not color, should provide you a lot of information in black and white. Other than that, you get a centrally placed infotainment display which should be Apple CarPlay and Android Auto compliant. Beneath that, you get an AC control panel which is a two-zone air conditioner, so the front passenger and the driver can set temperatures according to their comfort. Apart from that, if you notice, both door pads at the front have space for two bottles each, and there's also a tiny cavity above the glove box so that you can place a few things in there. There's also a central armrest between the driver and the passenger seat, under which we think there should be some more storage space too. Mahindra harps on the fact that they've paid attention to the fit and finish and quality of materials inside the cabin, although we reserve our opinion once we see the car in flesh. Now, powering this car will be a 1.5 liter diesel engine which also powers the Mahindra Marazzo, where it makes 123 hp and 300 newton meters of torque. The same engine will also perform propelling duties here and will be mated to a 6-speed transmission, although power details are not known yet. To be launched in February 2019 and should compete with top spec variants of the Brezza and the Nexon and the EcoSport, whereas it will also cover a few variants of the Creta and the to-be launched Nissan Kicks. Now, although this is a SsangYong Tivoli, Mahindra also has tuned the suspension so that it suits Indian conditions, and that should show once this car comes down the road. They also say that they have tuned the engine and the package so that it also is a fun to drive package. So that's all the dope we have on the Mahindra XUV 300 until now. We'll come back more with more details as and when they arrive. Until then, do subscribe to the channel. If you did like this video, if you found it useful, do hit that like button, share it with your friends. Until next time, my name is Karan, this is Motoroids. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye.